God took care of Ruth and Naomi, so I know he'll take care of me and my homie.
Welcome everybody to the Jay Sadie Variety Show, and praise the Lord.
Well, howdy everybody. I'm Jay Sadie Gray, and I'm here with my sister, Lenny. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, today we're talking about being ashamed and having shame. But first, we have a song for you by Mariah Peters titled, No Shame.
You were just saying at the end of the other line, what you said you'd never do again, you did it one more time. You're crushed and you're hopeless, 'cause you fell to the weakness. You feel like a fool, wonder if there's grace enough for you.
Chapter of Ruth swallowed her pride and went back to her hometown of Bethlehem. She was ashamed for leaving because she felt God was angry with her and still wanted her name changed to Mara, which means bitter. Because she felt God was bitter towards her, she left full and came back empty. Well, we all do things at times in our lives that we should be ashamed of. But God will forgive if we truly repent. You know, there's a verse in Jeremiah where it talks about Israel doing such shameful things that they have lost their ability to blush. You'll find it in the 6th chapter in the 15th verse, which states, "Were they ashamed when they had committed abomination? Nay, they were not at all ashamed. Neither could they blush. Therefore, they shall fall among them that fall, and at the time that I visit them, they shall be cast down, saith the Lord." These days, it seems like we have lost our ability to blush. Watching some television comedy shows sometimes is just inappropriate to watch ourselves, much less to watch with children or teenagers. The commercials themselves are rough also. Then just go shopping. You will find the modesty and dress for everyone shows the loss of shame. If you take a vacation on the beach, the people aren't blushing. They are just sunburned. It may seem funny to say, but it would be a good thing if we had a little bit of shame. You know, on cars, they have a thing called a governor. It limits how fast you can go. That's what we need in our life, a governor that will limit us so we don't show our shame, as the old people would say. You can have a governor in your life. All you have to do is accept Jesus. Just pray this prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, please forgive me of my sin. I believe that Jesus is your Son, and that He died on the cross, and He rose from the dead. Please govern my life so I live for you. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, you're saved if you believed and prayed that prayer. Let a saved loved one know, and a great thing to do is to read your Bible daily to build up your faith. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Well, it's song time again. Here is Keith Wonder Boy Johnson singing Shame on You.
You know, in today's society, we have a lot of evil spirits out there. And we have a lot of people that know right from wrong, but that still continue to do wrong. Now, a friend of ours told y'all a few years ago, and I don't think that you got the message. So we gonna tell you again, and that message is shame.
poem by Deborah Ann titled, All Because of His Name. He who had no fault, no witness to defame, was declared guilty, all because of his name. He who broke no law, nor to Satan did he obey, was crucified to death for iniquity that day. He who did no wrong was put to public shame, ridiculed upon the cross, all because of his name. He who had no sin took the punishment for us, with each piercing stab on him that was thrust. He who had no fault took our share of shame, so we could forgive all who call upon his name. Well, the clock on the wall shows we're about out of time. Isn't that right, Lenny?
That's right, Sadie.
Lenny and I thank you so much for listening, and we have you on our prayer list. Also, if you have a prayer request you would like Lenny and I to pray about, send us a private message on Facebook at J. Sadie Gray, G-R-A-Y, or our website is jsadiegray.com, and leave us a message there. We have a link to a little free ebook for you we wrote titled Survive to Thrive, 5 Survival Tips Inspired by the Book of Ruth. Download it free and let us know what you think. Well, we're going to leave you with the Marshall family singing Things I Used to Do. And have a blessed week.
The things I used to say, I don't say no more. Things I used to say, I don't say no more. Things I used to say, I don't say no more. For the Lord's got his eyes on me.
Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more, for the Lord's made a change in me.
Now the places I used to go, I don't go no more. Places I used to go, I don't go no more. Places I used to go, I don't go no more. For the Lord got his eyes on me.
Yes, he has.
Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. For the Lord's made a change in me. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, I don't do no more. For the Lord's made a change in me.
God took care of Ruth.
On behalf of Lenny and myself,
Jay Sadie Gray. Let's pray that soon the sun will reign. God bless you all in Jesus' name.